The final honor of the evening is one that I personally deeply relate to, because the award is named for the man who we are all truly descended from, the great Les Paul. Representing Les Paul Foundation, please welcome Mr. Jeff Salmon.
Thank you. This is quite an honor. First, I'd like to thank Hillel, David, and the rest of the team for creating the Les Paul Award to honor those who have set the highest standards of excellence in the creative application of recording technology. I also want to say thanks to all of you in this room for getting music from point A, the performance, to point B, our ears. You know, the mission of the Les Paul Foundation is to honor and remember Les's life, spirit, and legacy by supporting music education, engineering, and innovation, as well as medical research, especially related to the hearing impaired. I'd ask that you please visit our website, and thank you in advance for your support. I also just wanted to mention some of our partners that are here tonight: Little Kids Rock, HEAR, Discovery World Museum, Guitars for Vets, and Hearing Health Foundation. Please give them a round of applause. They're doing some great, great work. In the past, the Les Paul Award has recognized such great music legends as Stevie Wonder, Peter Gabriel, and last year's recipient, Pete Townsend. And tonight, I'm honored, on behalf of the Les Paul Foundation, to be presenting this year's award to Todd Rundgren. A good friend of Todd's who couldn't be here tonight sent this message, so if we could please roll the video.
Well, Todd, it's your old pal, Paul Schaefer, and I can't tell you how thrilled I am that you are receiving the Les Paul Award tonight. Because like Les Paul, you too, sir, are a visionary. When you first came on the scene, you were a little child, really. You were younger than a child. You had a childlike sensibility because you were really only 2 years old. And yet your writing, your songwriting ability, fully formed. Your singing like a bird, your arranging to die for. When you started to do the Letterman show, I would say the first time was probably back in the 80s. It was one of the biggest thrills that I've ever had playing with an artist, because your songwriting is deceptively simple, yet incredibly sophisticated. Yet as a piano player who can barely, you know, put two fingers together on the keys, it seems to just flow so naturally as an instrumentalist. You got that going for you too, besides which you are a guitar god. So I can't think of anybody more deserving of this award, and I'm thrilled to be asked to say a few words to you, for you, on your behalf, to the assembled multitude. Todd Rundgren, receiver of tonight's Les Paul Award, you, sir, are a genius.
You know, I started thinking about the many things that Les and Todd had in common. Both are incredible guitar players who could tell a musical story that could make you cry. Both also amazing self-producers, that rare brand of talent that allowed them to excel on both sides of the studio glass. And any of you who knew Les knew he was a stickler for getting the sound just right. I've heard from so many people who said when they put a Les Paul 78 on the turntable back in the 50s, the sound just jumped out of the speaker. Les was always chasing sound, and I know tonight's recipient is a sound chaser as well. So let's take a look back at the audiovisual wizardry of Todd.